James Johnson left the ghettos of Buffalo, New York to become super freak superstar Rick James and ride a wave of success to the top of the record charts, selling 15 million copies of one album alone. But the road to success led Rick right back to where it all began.
Buffalo's my home, you know, and it always has been, and it always will be. And I'm much more comfortable there than I think I am in Hollywood or New York. You know, when I go to Buffalo, it's really a time in my life where I can really just chill out. I bought this home when I was just starting to happen, 1978, and I have a recording studio of my own. It has an indoor pool and jacuzzi, and there's horses and the tennis court. And my mom is there, you know, and she's getting older, and it's nice just to be around her, you know. I'm trying to buy the neighborhood up, really. It's a really nice area. It's about 25 minutes, 30 minutes from Buffalo. It's in the country, and it's a sanctuary for me. It really gives me a good balance on life, you know. It's a real nice place to be, to know that your roots are right next to you, and whatever you need them for strength, you go there. I grew up a family of eight, four boys, four girls. A very deep heartthrob of the ghetto, where we had a friendly pets. You know, we had very nice-sized rats we used to play with. The cockroaches used to have track meets with them. Used to find them in all the food. Growing up in the ghetto was opening up in the morning and drinking Kool-Aid out of a peanut butter glass and opening up puff rice and having a roach come out. Says hi, you know. It was very rough. I go to the same project sometime, to this very same home that that the eight of us were raised in, same old two-bedroom little house, and I look around there, and I go inside, and it's an old black family that's there, and they have a son going to school, and I go inside, you know, just to feel it and see how they're doing. You know, I keep an eye on them, too, because I feel like they're family. I think it's important, coming up under such strenuous, you know, terrible conditions, that someone tells them that it's all right. We can get out of this situation. I don't believe that old cliche in the ghetto that, you know, the man holds me here, you know, and that this, you know, I can't get up out of this, you know. Anyone can get up out of anything, you know, it's all about motivation. I was a professional juvenile delinquent. The art of juvenile delinquency was perfected by myself and my friends. If you had a Chevy and the ignition was straight up, it was gone. I sang on street corners, and I was like a hoodlum, you know. I was like one of those kids who really didn't care much about school. I went to five high schools in Buffalo. I mean, I go to one and kick him out, and I go to another one and kick him out, and I go to another one, you know. And I visited most of the high schools. If I had to do it all over again, I think I would have stuck to school, because most of the things I learned after I got out of school, because I hate the thought of being stupid. So I read and read and, you know, tried to enhance my mind.
Rick's inspiration has always been his mother, Betty, who found an unusual way for 21 years to support her family.
She ran numbers, some thing called the numbers rackets. And I'm not at all ashamed to say what my mother did. She ran numbers to keep us all eating. And from it, she sent my brother to one of the top law schools in the country. And my sister's a CPA accountant. And she did very well with all eight, you know, and she's a very, very strong woman.
And the superstar inherited that same strength and determination.
I thought I was going to be a big star. After the goo-goo da-da, I was determined. The stardom was, when I first saw television, I knew what a Rolls Royce was when I was in the ghetto. I did not want a Cadillac. I wanted a Rolls Royce.
When he struck gold, Rick fulfilled that dream, blowing millions on high living. But the dream turned into a nightmare in 1979 when he became seriously ill and discovered he was $1 million in debt.
After a bad experience with a very bad accountant and spending a lot of money on, I was off into drugs then at that time, seriously. And it was like a time in my life when things were happening real fast, and I didn't quite have a serious grip on, on things, you know. I was writing good songs, I felt, but I wasn't acting as a person wholly, you know. And I kind of blew a lot of money, cars and women and drugs, and just basically having a wonderful time. Going broke turned me around. That's one of the things that turned me around. And being in the hospital, I had a time to think, you know. And I remember an agent came to me and said to me, I was going to have one of the biggest money offers in my life to play a certain stadium. And I was sick in the bed, dying. And my doctor came and said, and I was going to get out the bed and go play this gig because it was all this money. And I needed the money. And my doctor said, well, you can go play this gig and die because by the time you get there, I know they're going to take me by private plane and take me on ambulance and put me on the stage. And I was going to get up and, you know, go, yeah, hey, and take this money. He said, you can go do this, but you'll die. He said, well, you can stay in this bed and recuperate because, you know, after you die, people forget. And I said, well, I think I'll live. And I really got myself together.
Rick threw himself right back into the high voltage world of rock music. Today, he's a powerhouse again, not only handling his own career, but managing a family of other bands.
I'm a very serious person when it comes to my art, very, very serious about my life, because I do not joke around with the blessing that I have. You know, it's nothing to play with. I mean, I like many things, you know, I mean, do I love sex? Yes, abundantly. Do I love women? Yes, totally. Do I love the fact that I have lots of money and have and I'm rich and famous? And yes, that's real great. But that means nothing compared to what I'm about in here. Because in here I'm about trying to bring an end to all of that for others and myself and just making people happy. That's what gets me on, making people happy.
Rick James making music and millions.